Stay tuned to STV for more rock
from
Dillon Fitz.
Hi, we're here with John Svara.
Oh man, you're not gonna use that.
Hi, we're here with John Svara, who's recently featured in the college section of Rolling Stone magazine. Now, John, you've been performing for how long now?
All my life, 21 years and 11 months.
Really? That's good. And you were recently in Rolling Stone magazine. Now, how did you manage that?
Well, I sent them a tape and had a friend of mine who's a publicist make some calls to follow it up and just got in.
Yeah.
They said that they had a lot of real unprofessional sort of college productions. Probably done it at studios just like this all over the country. And I guess they thought my tape was a little bit cleaner than that or something.
Well, they called you a Chapel Hill music leader. Do you feel yourself to be that role? Or?
Not really. I think a lot of people probably berate me for that phrase.
That could be true. What do you consider yourself fitting in the Chapel Hill music community?
Well, good question. There are a lot of students in this town, a lot of student musicians, and also a lot of musicians who are graduated or never had anything to do with the university. And I'm not sure that the students are always considered to be as serious members of the musical community as they might be. So there's a strong acoustic faction, I think, in this town, and I guess I would fit somewhere in there.
You're doing the band thing now, aren't you, John?
A lot of the time, yeah. John Gillespie of Nikki Mise Hibachi plays bass, and Mark Simonson plays drums.
Are they known as the Reptiles?
Well, against their better judgment, they are known as the Reptiles for the time being.
Do you like the band thing? Do you like the solo thing?
I like being able to do both. I like having the other musicians there for a show so that I can sort of vary things. It's nice to do a solo set, but then also have other musicians to have a big full band sound. I'm going to play a song called Lullabies that Mark, my drummer, can never remember the name because it's kind of a fast song. It doesn't sound like a lullaby, but the song is called Lullabies.
Myself, time.
blend of decibel guitar pop and soulful vocals, Dillon Fence has collected many fans since its formation nearly 4 years ago.
Hi, my name's Scott. I play drums with Dillon Fence for about 2 years. And my nicknames start with the name anything with CH.
My name is Greg. And I play guitar and sing. And I'm in charge of giving Scott nicknames that start with CH. Chipples, Chirples, Chauncey, Chap, Chitterling.
Change. I'm Chris, 24, asparagus. And I play bass guitar.
You're an asparagus? I'm a feces.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Can I call you number two?
Running out the foursome is guitarist Kent Alphen. We caught up with the band recently at the Cat's Cradle, playing for yet another full house. As usual, the guys had plenty to say, but about what, we're not sure.
We started in high school. Chris and I, we were typical shunned high school students. We picked up guitars. And then we went to college. And I met Kent in college. We started playing lots of guitar together, shared a lot of common loves in music. And then we found Scott playing in a Holiday Inn cover band on I-95.
I remember Jiggers, it was. Was the name of the lounge? He was playing Sweet Home Alabama when it was
Mingles. It was Mingles. And the name of the band was The Blend.
We love Sweet Home Alabama.
A nice blend of 60s, 70s, and 80s rock. All the hits.
And 3 years later, here we are.
Like so many bands in the area, Dillon Fence enjoys calling Chapel Hill home.
It is our home base. It's pretty happening right now. It's fun to play here. We have a good following as do a lot of other groups. Like the Belt, one of my favorites.
Lots of great bands. Chicken Wire Gang.
Teasing the Korean.
Southern Culture on the Skids.
What I like about the Chapel Hill music scene is that all the bands, most of them, tend to, sort of, get together really well. Just doing this kind of thing. And
because we all work at restaurants and
everybody gets along really, really well. A lot of other cities you see bands scrapping and
very competitive.
Just being very competitive. And here, since we've got such a broad spectrum, really, of music here, nobody's treading on anyone else's toes, and we help each other out.
You know, we started out, we sounded a lot like a British pop band from the early 80s. But I don't know, me personally, the more I listened to that music, the more I sort of went back to the roots of where that came from. And the past year, couple of years, I've been listening to a lot of people like Marvin Gaye and a lot of old Motown. And it's influenced my songwriting a lot in that sense because that's where a lot of today's pop gets its ideas from, and I do too.
The band's namesake comes from an actual fence on Interstate 95.
A couple of my high school friends had seen this junkyard fence down in Dillon, South Carolina, and went crazy and talked about it for months. And when we were discussing names, we were tossing around stories, and that came up, and that seemed as good a name as any.
It's southern, it's colorful. Says it all.
Here's a colorful southern tune off their debut CD, a song called Francis. We'll be right back. Like any band, Dillon Fence hopes to make it big someday. Specifically, where do they hope to be in 5 years?
Driving that sweet Beamer.
Sweet Beamer!
Well, we really, I think what we'd really like to do is be playing a lot of nightclubs, you know. Not really. We've been playing nightclubs for a while. We're ready to do something else.
The big arenas. Walnut Grove, Creek, thing.
Walnut.
Love to play there.
No, we're having a good time. We just want to make music, basically. We want to make records and make a living at it and not have to get real jobs. Mm. You know, because this is fun and it beats working. So,
I'll say, yeah.
Kids, don't go to college. Go out and buy an electric guitar.
Join a band.
After spending the evening with the band, it's easy to understand why fans packed their shows night after night. They played for over 2 hours, and the crowd still wanted more. Here's one of the reasons for their popularity, a song called I Will Break.
Well, it seems like a dream, but I just can't believe it anymore. Yeah, I don't know. My soul hurts and I'm stuck, but I just can't accept.
Thank you.
For you up-and-coming bands out there, here's some words of wisdom from Dillon fans.
If there's one thing I would recommend is to get a Marvin Gaye anthology, because that guy was talented. He wrote great songs. That's my little suggestion.
Up-and-coming bands, keep at
the same thing
it.
You guys did.
Stick together.
No, and record your own music, perhaps. And
don't go to college. Spend all your money on musical equipment.
Become a waiter.
Learn your waiting skills. Learn to wait tables.
And wait time-wise, because it takes a long time to
fail.
Until you're driving that sweet Beamer.
If the band continues to write songs like this one, their break should be right around the corner. This is called Sad Inheritance. Great group of guys, and a great band as well. Next time they're in town, check them out, because that sweet Beamer is right around the corner, ready to take them to stardom.
They were raising a circus tent. Remember the ease there, just for a week or two. The ground was so flat, so the sky was bigger. Finally, it was warm enough to stay outside after dark. But the grass was cool, oh, it smelled like sleep. It was almost summer. They were raising a circus tent.
So what do you get out of for selling the show?
Well, some of them actually come from dreams. I like to make songs out of things that I imagine or see. Usually visual images work real well for me in songs. And it just has to be something that strikes me sufficiently to keep working on it.
See your career going
straight to the top, all the way, international stardom.
Do you see yourself doing Jell-O commercials?
Certainly, within weeks, I think.